Finally, we got our hands on the Shearwater Teric. After we've tested the Perdix, we were quite enthusiastic about the company and about the computers they make. So we couldn't wait to hit the water with this computer, and it didn't disappoint, but we're not sure if we would buy it. So the Teric is a watch size computer, and this is one of the main benefits if you compare it to other high-end technical diving capable computers, which are usually a lot bigger. This one is watch size, and from afar you would say it's a smartwatch, so you can practically wear it every day. But that doesn't mean you should wear it every day. For me, since I'm not a watch person, so I'm not wearing a watch either way, and it's kind of big for me. It's pretty fat and pretty big, so on my tiny wrist it's just too big for me. And the Teric comes with a rubber strap, which also has an extension. The strap is comfortable and easy to wear. There's also some aftermarket NATO straps available. Those are only $12.99, which is crazy cheap if you compare it to other companies like Suunto. There's no official bungee mount for the Teric because Shearwater believes its strap is more than strong enough, so you don't need one. There are several aftermarket bungee mounts which you can buy, and some people just remove the strap and put the bungee right through the holes here, but these are pretty small, so you end up with a thin bungee anyways. So the single best feature of the Teric is its display. It's an AMOLED color display, and it's really bright and really easy to read under all circumstances. And they put a sapphire crystal cover on it so it doesn't scratch. This is a market loaner from Shearwater, and I'm pretty sure it's pretty banged up because you can see it on the rim, but the glass is still scratch free. If you're still anxious about scratching up your Teric, you can buy a scratch guard, but in my opinion it's completely useless because it's scratch free, baby. Like I said, the screen is extremely easy to read even in the most bright conditions. We've tested it out in the Mediterranean on Ibiza, and there was no instance where we couldn't read the screen. You can adjust the brightness in several levels. This does affect the battery a bit, and also you can customize the colors of the numbers in 15 different colors. The list of dives you can make with the Teric is pretty long. There are several modes you can use. Of course, there's normal recreational diving mode. There's open circuit technical diving mode. You can dive with closed circuit rebreathers. There's a free dive mode, and you can use the Teric as a bottom timer. When you go underwater and dive with the Teric, it's easy to read what you need because they have made sure that there's not too much clutter or information on the screen. So at one glance, you just get the information you need. In recreational mode, it's possible to dive up to 99% of oxygen. There's also one function which you don't see as much on other computers, which is the TTS function. This stands for time to surface, and this gives the exact time you will need to go back to the surface, including all stops and ascent time. Having this information can be really helpful, especially if you compare it with the amount of air you still got. Another thing we liked a lot was the vibration function. This is instead of the beep. The beep is still there, but it's god awful. We all know those divers which are beep, 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 beep. So that's why you can set it to vibrate. Instead of the beep, you have vibration. You can also set both if you want to. The vibration is only really noticeable when you're wearing a thin suit. So in a dry suit, better go back to the beep. When you're underwater with the Shearwater Teric, you might see a lot of abbreviations like NDL, no deagle limit, DTS, time to surface. This might be a bit confusing at first if you don't read the manual like we did, but if you read the manual once, you will know all these and it's a lot easier to dive with. So do that. In technical dive mode, the computer displays pretty much the same as in recreational dive mode, but there are two things added, the PPO2 and the current gas you're diving with. These are of course essential things to know, especially if you want to make a gas switch, which is also possible with the Teric. But wait, there's more. There are a few features we really made us fall in love with the Teric. Example of that is the vibration function, which we talked about earlier. You can actually test this before your dive, so you can put it on your suit and feel if you notice the vibration and make adjustments according to that. What we also love is the plan function. Most computers have a plan function that when you want to dive again, you can check at that time what your depth limit or no decompression time is, but that's for that time. What the Teric does, you can plan ahead, like I'm going into the water in an hour, what will my no deco time be by then? And this is a feature we haven't seen in a lot of computers. It is even possible to do decompression dive planning, and there's special software available for free on the Shearwater website. The Perdix has 4 buttons and is pretty easy to operate. The buttons are a bit larger than an other watch-like computers, but it's still a watch. If you are wearing thick gloves, it might be hard to press and navigate the menus. The menu of the Perdix is quite easy to navigate, and adjusting things is quite easy. Even without studying the manual very hard, you can find your way in the computer and adjust things you need. So, yes and no. First of all, yes, we love the Teric. It's a great computer. It has all the capabilities you might expect of a Shearwater. The customer support is pretty amazing. You just get a wonderful, extremely great computer. But I wouldn't buy this because, first of all, I'm not a watch person. I wouldn't wear this all day long, and it isn't about the watch, but I'm not a watch person. Second, if I want to buy a technical dive computer, this might mean that I'm going to do technical deep dives wearing gloves, and I don't think a watch size computer is the way to go because it's quite hard to push the buttons and make transfers. I will go for the Perdix instead. Nonetheless, it's a great, great computer. You wouldn't regret it if you bought it. It just works awesome.